save, and that's why he came up with a short shot.
Complaining at that time, Barkley was shoved in the back. That's why he didn't come up with the rebound.
Here's Jordan. Barkley for three. Whoa! And Barkley with a 6-3-pointer in last season's NBA final. Barkley hitting for the Seattle Center. Barkley came up.
It was supposed to be a coronation, another fan at home, another celebration, a three-peat, a dynasty. Instead, the only thing hung after Game 5 of these NBA Finals were the heads of the Chicago Bulls.
It is our destiny to win the World Championship. We want us to win the World Championship.
Whether divine inspiration plays a part in this day's question, but there's no questioning the fervor with which Barkley is spreading the word. Sometimes he does it with a smile, but it's more than just talk. The Phoenix Suns have become much more combative, more sure of themselves. But the championship ball, even if the Bulls come out of Phoenix with the title, they will have sweated for it. In the last few games in Chicago, this series has been redefined. The Suns simply will not back down from the Bulls. Still flirting with history, but they could be flirting with disaster as well. 5 times in these playoffs, the Phoenix Suns have faced elimination. 5 times they won. After what happened this unstoppable past week in Chicago, who's to say they can't do it again?
I didn't believe in my heart that it is our destiny.
The 1993 NBA Finals. Tonight, Game 6 between the Chicago Bulls and the Phoenix Suns.
Less than 48 hours ago, we were in Chicago, where the consensus was the Bulls were about to make history, the Suns were about to be history. Instead, the Suns canceled the celebration in Chicago and ignited one of their own here in the desert. Look at this. 12,000 of the faithful greeting the Mar-a-Lago in the wee hours Saturday morning. Welcome to Game 6, everybody. I'm Bob Costas, and so here we are at the America West Arena. Many of us are surprised to be spending Father's Day here. I mean, let's face it, the whole ebb and flow of this series has confounded even the deepest thinkers in sports. To put it bluntly, if Chicago wins tonight, it's very hard to conceive of Phoenix winning 2 of 3 in Chicago to bring the series back here. All right, go figure. And in fact, when we checked out of Phoenix after Game 2, the Chicago Bulls, the overwhelming majority of the press corps, and almost everyone else except the Suns themselves, thought we wouldn't be seeing Phoenix anytime soon. So what are we to make now of where things stand? True, the Suns have renewed confidence, home floor, and they appear fresher late in these hard-fought games. And this, Game 6, is a quick turnaround. Factors which appear to favor Phoenix. On the other hand, the road team has won four of the five games in this series, and Chicago has won all three games they've played in Cleveland. Two in this series, one in the regular season. So, what are we to make of these conflicting trends? Do the Bulls come in here dragging while the Suns are exhilarated, or are the Bulls, as they have so often been in the past, energized by a challenge, fueled by anger at the impudence of the underdog and the inconvenience of a return trip to the 112-degree heat of the desert? But of course, it is a dry heat. One common Chicago is quite clearly displeased.
As much as we can limit the confidence that the team may have, it's better for us, and I think if we can get it done now, we may be facing Tiger back in the fifth and finish. So I told you, I'm not going back to Kansas. Yeah, if you guys want to go back and play, you're going by yourself. I'm going to get it over with right now.
Somehow Michael was persuaded to board the starter, therefore all the starting lineups are intact except for ours. Magic Johnson has taken a pass tonight to attend the wedding of his brother Larry this weekend in Lansing, Michigan. But Marv and Mike are in the house, and we head down to the floor to join them now.
All right, Bob, now sorry you and Magic were adamant in making the point early in Game 5 on Friday night that if the Suns were to turn it around, they must do it through Charles Barkley. And as it didn't turn out, all the positives did arrive.